Look at the Minnesota Department of Education's 2023 graduation data. Something else interesting caught our eye. High school students across the state are missing crucial class credits. Kaya Edwards explains what one district's doing to help teens march in May.
Lauren, we were invited to Johnson High School in St. Paul to see how leaders there are trying to help this year's seniors graduate after seeing fewer graduate last year.
The high school students who graduated last year were just freshmen when COVID-19 was declared a pandemic.
Some kids didn't want to wear them. Some teachers were freaking out, like, they don't have their mask on.
Johnson High School Principal Jamil Payton says many students suffered academically and socially. The class of 2023 was smaller than they'd hoped.
According to the report that came out, we dropped down. We have to look at, as a school, as adults, like, what are we doing that's working and what are we doing that we might need to revise?
The Minnesota Department of Education reports four-year graduation rates dipped slightly statewide, and that in this district, St. Paul Public Schools, just 68% of students graduated, a 7% drop from the previous year, and the third consecutive year there's a decline. But district leaders say it's important to include summer graduates.
In other years, summer graduates would have been counted in the overall total.
Adam Coons is assistant superintendent.
The story isn't about the declining graduation rate for me. It's about the hard work that those students have done to get out of that hole and to then succeed and graduate, whether or not it was on time or really close to on time.
District-wide, there are opportunities to make up class credits, he says.
We have experiential credit recovery, which is something we're really proud of, where students get to do things like canoe with wilderness inquiry as a part of the way they re-earn science and health credits.
At Johnson, there's a freshman focus class and job and college readiness programming for juniors. And Principal Payton says changes were made this year to help more students graduate.
This year we had an interventionist and a teacher. So the teacher was able to really work with their colleagues to find out what these students were missing.
Similarly, in Minneapolis public schools, the state report showed an almost 9% drop in graduation rates. But the district says when you include summer graduates, the dip is closer to 3% from the previous year, not 9%. Lauren?
All right, Kaya, thank you.